Hi, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to set up a local environment for AEM as a cloud service development. As discussed earlier, Adobe Experience Manager as a cloud service is the cloud native way of leveraging the AEM applications. So this will provide lot of benefits. So already we discussed, so you can refer those videos. Also, like lot of Adobe materials available, please refer that. I'm going to set up in Windows machine the development environment. The steps will vary little bit for Linux system. As a first step, we need to download all the required softwares from experience.adobe.com. So let me do that. Let me go to experience.adobe.com. There if you go, you can see a section called software distribution. Just click on that. Now here you can see general AEM experience manager and AEM as a cloud service. The general section will have all this JDK and all those installables. Now if I go to Adobe Experience Manager, it will have all the CFP patches, service packs and all those hot fixes, all those installables. If I go to AEMS Cloud Service, this will have the AEM SDK. So you need to download the latest Java version from this general tab. So I downloaded Oracle JDK 11.0.6 version. So let me go to for Windows. So this one I downloaded Oracle JDK 11.06 for Windows 6 64. So because this is the minimum requirement, or the 11 is the minimum requirement for cloud service. Now go back to AEMS cloud service. So here you need to download the SDK. I downloaded the latest file. So this is uploaded recently. So I uploaded this this file, AEM SDK file. Now let me go back to where I downloaded. I downloaded here. This is the file, this is the SDK file, this is the JDK file. As a first step, I extracted JDK to this folder, dev JDK 11.06. This is the JDK I'm going to use it for running the AEM install. Now we extract the SDK file. This is the SDK file I extracted into that. This will have another zip file for dispatcher tools. So I extracted that also. Maybe I will explain what is inside that later. Then this have a quickstart file, AEM quickstart file. Also there is a file called like Unix, dispatcher tools Unix, but anyway we are not going to use it because I am configuring it in the Windows. So I am planning to install the published instance. So then what we need to do is we need to rename this quickstart file with the required naming convention. So what I did is I copied this file, I went to dev folder, I created again one folder called publish. So here if you see like AEM SDK publish port number 4503, you need to have the license file. This will start the, when I am starting the instance, it will start the publish instance. For that, as a first step, you need to set this Java environment variables. So if you see here, I am setting the Java home. I am pointing to the JDK 11.0.6. Again, I am setting the path, Java home slash bin, then path. So now if I check the Java version, it's pointing to 11.0.6. That is expected for the AEM instance. Now after that, I am going and executing. This is the same thing. There is nothing different. Java minus jar, then AEM SDK, the jar file name. So it will start the instance. So it will ask you the admin password. Enter the admin password. So once the server starts up, it may take some time. Once it is started, now you will be able to access the server URLs. You can access the CRXT. You can access the CRXT. So it means the server is installed successfully, but it's not having any content enabled. So for that, what you can do is you can download the weekend website content, the full package from this specific URL, GitHub, Adobe AEM guides weekend slash release. So I just downloaded this one, AEM guides weekend all 0.0.2.zip. So I'm having it here. I downloaded this. Now what I did is I installed that to this server. You can upload the package and just install it. so that it will configure the site. If I go back here, yeah, you can see here that we can't, it will have all the site details. Also, if you go to apps, it will have the weekend and weekend packages. Also, it will have the core components also. Okay, now let me go and access it. So, if I access 4503, it will give me the weekend default page. So, the site looks to be fine. It's loading as expected. Yeah, this completes the AEM published instance setup for AEM cloud service development. Let us see now how to install the dispatcher. The dispatcher is enabled locally through the Docker image. The Docker image is part of the download, I will show you. The required configuration files are placed in deployment folder outside of Docker image. So the configuration, the dispatcher configuration file like form file or any configuration files are outside of the Docker image. We need to specify through the deployment folder. So we need to extract the zip file, the dispatcher zip file. I already done it. So if you see here, you can see a folder called bin. So yeah, this will have two tools. One is validator. So the validator is a kind of is a CLI tool, helps to validate the dispatcher configurations with cloud standard. So then if there is any issue, it will report to you so that we can fix the issue. So then Docker run, so it will help you to initiate the Docker image. So this is the Docker image for the archive for the dispatcher publish. Now, before starting the installation of dispatcher, ensure the latest version of Docker desktop software is installed on your machine so that you can download from this specific URL. Docker desktop then download for Windows, so that and that install that. Now okay, let's now start installing the dispatcher. As a first step, we need to validate the dispatcher config. So if you see the default dispatcher configs kept under this particular folder src conf.conf.dispatcher.d. So now we need to validate so that it will create a out folder. So that will have all the required validated files to run the dispatcher locally through this Docker image. So let me do that. This is the tool. Let me go and do a cd to this. This is where the tool is available, the extracted one. After that, try to execute this command validator.exe full minus d. Then this is the folder where you want to generate the validated configuration. I created a folder. We don't want to create out folder, but you need to specify what is the location. Then this is the folder where the source configurations are available. So default configurations. So yeah, you execute this command. So once you execute, this will create that out folder and validate those configuration. So do that. Yeah, so it's saying like folder already exists and not empty, so means like it's already created, so it's not creating it again. Maybe you can delete it and again you can recreate it. So my case it's already created. Yeah, now the out folder is created. Now what we need to do is like maybe let me show you the out folder where it is created. Go to dev, this is my out folder. Yeah, this will have all the configurations, like whatever the configuration required to run the dispatcher in the Docker image, client headers, and maybe we can I can post another video how details on these files and how it is organized and how we can do the development. Okay, so now the out folder is ready. Now we need to start the Docker image. For that we need to run this specific command, so docker.run .cmd. So then where is the out folder? So this is the location of the out folder. Then you can specify the host.docker.internal. This means it's referring the localhost. Then port number 4503. Then this is the port number where your dispatcher should be running. So this command you can run. So I already run that command. So if you see here, this is the comment, same comment. So it will start the server in the 8080 port. So there is some more details, maybe I will talk in another video, like how to enable the log levels, change the log levels for this dispatcher server, and how to view the logs. So maybe we can cover it in another video. Yeah, so now the server is already started. So once you execute the command, it will start the dispatcher. Now let me go and try to access the server. It should be able to access. Yeah, so now I am able to access the weekend website, the default website, through the 8080 port. So means like through the dispatcher. So if you want to modify, you can modify any configurations. So my perspective, overall, there is not much different from the AEM perspective. I can see only the major difference is from AEM perspective, the structure of the project, because we are using R-Type 22, so there is a lot of changes. Then other than that, I am not seeing much difference. So then from the dispatcher perspective, obviously it's different. We are earlier, we used to have a challenge on running the dispatcher in Windows machine. Yes, there is no 2.4 module available, then we need to go with 2.2 Apache. So maybe that issue is resolved now. So it's just a Docker image, so you can run in Windows machine also. Okay, so thanks all for watching the video. In our next video, maybe we can see how to develop for AEM as a cloud service, how to develop for dispatcher changes, how to do the AEM project, a new project for cloud service. So see you all in the next video.